Thank you very much, President Karzai, for welcoming me back to Afghanistan on such a beautiful day here in Kabul. I have very much appreciated our long and friendly relationship and the opportunity to work with you first as a senator and now as Secretary of State on behalf of a future of peace, prosperity, and stability for the people of Afghanistan. No people in the world deserve it more. And our efforts will continue. And I thank you for your leadership. Today, President Karzai and I discussed the challenges that we face, but also the opportunities that we have in the partnership between the United States and Afghanistan. Let me emphasize 4 points. First, we are focused on the shared goal of a stable, sovereign, independent, and prosperous Afghanistan, and a region free of al-Qaeda and extremists who would try to undermine the progress that the people of Afghanistan have made. Together, we are increasing the pressure on the Taliban to sharpen the choices that they face. They can either be part of Afghanistan's peaceful future and end 30 years of war, or face continuing assault. The despicable murder of Professor Rabbani was another reminder of the suffering that so many Afghan families have endured. They deserve a different future. And this brings me to the second point. The United States remains committed to an inclusive Afghan peace process that ends the conflict, protects the gains the Afghan people have achieved in the last 10 years, and helps bring greater stability and prosperity to the wider region. President Karzai and I have been clear about the outcomes of any negotiation. Insurgents must renounce violence, abandon al-Qaeda, and abide by the laws and constitution of Afghanistan, including its protections for women and minorities. The hard-won rights of Afghans, including women and minorities, must not be rolled back. And the growth of civil society must not be quashed, and the rule of law must not be threatened. Reconciliation is possible. Indeed, it represents the best hope for Afghanistan and the region. But success will take an inclusive national dialogue and sustained political effort, not only from Afghans, but from Afghanistan's neighbors. And that is the third point. Afghanistan's future is tied to the future of the entire region, both politically and economically. That is why the United States is working with Afghanistan to secure commitments from all of its neighbors to respect Afghan sovereignty and territorial integrity, and to support peace in Afghanistan. And it is why we have embraced the vision of Afghanistan at the heart of a new Silk Road, which will increase cross-border trade, investment that creates jobs and opportunities, and leads to broad-based prosperity. So let me say a word about Pakistan. We agree with President Karzai that Pakistan's cooperation is critical. Violent extremism has also taken the lives of thousands of Pakistanis as well as Afghans. And if you look beyond the history of distrust, it is clear that all countries in the region will have to work together for all the people in the region. So I urge the leaders of Afghanistan and Pakistan to resume their dialogue. We must focus on concrete measures to support peace and reconciliation in Afghanistan and to deny extremists safe havens in Pakistan. And the final point is that all of this work advances the plan for transition that Afghanistan and NATO agreed on at the summit in Lisbon. The transition to Afghan-led security has already begun, and we are identifying the next group of districts that will be ready to be handed over to the Afghans. This process will conclude by 2014, when Afghans will have full responsibility. But I want to be clear. The United States is making an enduring commitment to the people of Afghanistan that will not end in 2014. We will not abandon Afghanistan. We continue to make progress toward a new strategic partnership declaration that will provide a framework for long-term cooperation between the United States and Afghanistan. We hope that this agreement and the clarity it brings will bolster Afghan and regional confidence that this country will not again become a safe haven for terrorists or an area for competing regional interests. Our work depends on an ethic of shared responsibility. The United States will do our part. Now, over the years ahead, our role and our military presence will change significantly, but we will remain committed and engaged, and we will look to work with our Afghan partners. We will be looking to the Pakistanis to take the lead because the terrorists operating outside of Pakistan pose a threat to Pakistanis as well as to Afghans and others. And we will have ideas to share with the Pakistanis. We will certainly listen carefully to the ideas that they have. But our message is very clear. We're going to be fighting, we're going to be talking, and we're going to be building. And they can either be helping or hindering. But we are not going to stop our efforts to create a strong foundation for an Afghanistan that is free from interference, violence, conflict, and has a chance to chart its own future. So this is a time for clarity. It is a time for people to declare themselves as to how we intend to work together to reach goals that we happen to believe are in the mutual interests of Afghanistan, Pakistan, and the region. We want a very clear message to the insurgents on both sides of the border that we are going to fight you, and we are going to seek you in your safe havens, whether you're on the Afghan side or the Pakistani side. They must be dealt with.